Hello friends, Loadcell is the only transducer in any industry to which quality, quantity, legal compliance and tax clause like GST all are linked. Due to this, the accurate working of Loadcell becomes very important from raw material input to final product. It is the dynamic measurement in process control which decides the quality and quantity and finally legal compliance and GST calculation. There are many issues related to Loadcell which we face in day-to-day life in our any kind of industry. So today we will discuss about these. There are two characteristics any load cell can have, the repeatability and the linearity, on which you can blindly trust. This linearity is maintained from few grams to thousands of tons, and it is maintained for years as long as there is no disturbance in load transfer mechanism or problem in load cell alignment. In its simplest form, it converts force into electrical measurable quantity. Its basic element is a strain gauge, which is made of a metal wire placed like a shown in pic to form a strain gauge. The resistance of this wire is governed by this formula. So when an external force is applied to this wire, its length or area gets changed. This causes its resistance to change. Now we can measure this resistance change with the help of a Wheatstone bridge, as can show in terms of, and also we can show in terms of kilograms or tonnage. So simple. Now this strain gauge has a gauge factor which decides its sensitivity. This is ratio of unit change in resistance to the unit change in strain. The higher it is, the better is sensitivity. That means you will get more change in resistance for less applied force, which will be very easier for us to measure the change. Higher the sensitivity you choose, the higher you have to pay for on the cost part. This sensitivity is described in millivolt per volt. It is the main specs you have to provide while procuring a load cell. This is generally 2 millivolt per volt, or you can go for 3 millivolt or higher something. Now the load cell is no longer an active transducer. That means it does not produce any voltage or current signal its own, like thermocouple does. It is passive transducer. So you need to apply an external voltage to measure the change in resistance. Now this voltage is called excitation voltage. Now suppose you have a load cell whose sensitivity is 2 millivolt per volt and capacity is 100 tons. If it is supplied with 1 volt excitation voltage, so at 100 tons, 2 millivolt output will be the load cell. And load is reduced to 50 ton, then it will produce 1 millivolt at the output. Simple maths. So by measuring this millivolt with a multimeter, you can have a fair idea of what load its load is sensing. So this funda will help you while troubleshooting of a load cell. But here the excitation voltage is mostly given at 12 volt instead of 1 volt. Now my output at 110 will increase to 24 millivolt. So it will be good for measuring circuit to measure this higher output and makes measurement easy. Now this excitation is 12 volt AC or DC. Mostly this is DC voltage in static measurement such as weighbridg, weighing scale, where indicator and load cell is mounted in close proximity. But dynamic measurement system such we have in wave feeder, belt wear, solid flow feeder, it may have a high frequency AC voltage just to avoid induced voltage and noise superimposed over long cable running in plant operation. A single strain gauge is not used in load cell. A set of four strain gauges are used in a load cell to form a Wheatstone bridge. These four gauges have such orientation in load cell that two gauges are exposed to compression and two in tension. This kind of orientation will unbalance the bridge to the maximum, and so we will get more output. And since all the four strain gauges are confined in a load cell, the effect of ambient temperature change will be in same degree. So auto temperature is achieved automatically. There is a shield with four wires comes out of a load cell. And excitation voltage is given on the two of wires at opposite end of bridge, and signal output is taken from the other two ends. Now the load cell is described by four wire or six wire also. Four wire load cells are mostly used for local weighing machines or for static weighment where the weighing platform is located near the indicator. This also reduces the cost of a load cell. And these weighing scales are factory calibrated, and hence it is recommended that you never cut this cable of 4 wire load cell as they are factory calibrated for a fixed length. There is no cable length compensation in this type of weighing scales. Now the dynamic measurement in process plant is done at a very greater distance from the control room or panel. Here if we use the 4-wire load cell, then the weight accuracy is compromised by voltage drop in excitation voltage at across its cable length. Here is the reason. As long as there is no weight applied on the load cell, its Wheatstone bridge is balanced and the signal output is considered to be 0 millivolt. As soon as you put a load on the load cell, the bridge gets unbalanced and a millivolt signal output is generated and it causes current to flow in the bridge circuit. Now, as per Ohm's law, this current flow causes a considerable voltage drop across its cable length, resulting you get a less excitation voltage than it is supposed to be. You can see on the screen, when the current flow through the wire is zero, then voltage drop is zero. As the current starts flowing, Ohm's law is applied here and it causes voltage drop. If the cable length from the load cell to the indicator is very short, then this drop is and voltage is not reflected in the measurement and can be compensated as fixed. That's why only 4-wire load cells are used in local machine. But the cable length is supposed to be more due to remote measurement in the process plant. If a 4-wire load cell is used, then due to voltage drop, the accuracy of weight will be compromised. That's why a 6-wire load cell is used in remote measurement. In the same 4-wire load cell, 2 wires are extra added and which are connected to the parallel of the excitation supply wire. These are called sense wires. These 2 extra wires are meant for voltage drop compensation across cable length. These 2 sense wires are connected in the indicator in a circuit that checks how much voltage is actually reaching at the load cell, so that accordingly the weight measurement can be compensated for the voltage drop. Now your next question will be, voltage dip is also supposed to be there in these 2 extra wires called sense wire. What's this so special about these sense wire? No, there will be no voltage drop in these 2 extra wires because both these wires are connected on a high input impedance operational amplifier measurement circuit. The input stage of this operational amplifier consists of high impedance MOSFET, which draw almost negligible current from the source. Therefore, there will be no drop in these sense wire according to Ohm's law. Okay, this is exactly like a measuring voltage with a multimeter. While measuring voltage with a multimeter, it does not drain current from the source because the input impedance of the multimeter is in mega ohms. Clear now? Now let's shift focus to our static measurement. A construction of all kinds of static weighing scale is same. There are 4, 6, or 8 load cell are placed under a weighing platform according to platform geometry. This platform is mounted on these load cell in such a way that acting load on the platform is distributed on all load cell. Now these load cells are connected in parallel. That means the excitation wires are supplied in parallel and the signal output of the all load cells are connected in parallel, so that the output signal gets averaged out of all individual outputs from each load cell. Take care of the load cell by grounding all the load cell to one local earth pit nearby, so that all transient noise pulses should flow through the ground and thus protecting the measurement circuitry. At the time of installation, care must be taken whether 100% load is being transferred from platform to load cell or not. Otherwise, there may be an issue of repeatability. If such an issue arises, load cell alignment is needed. The industry uses various kinds of circular objects like hoppers, bunkers, tanks, etc., containing solid material or product. These circular objects are installed by placing 3 load cell placed apart 120 degree on a RCC or steel platform. It should be noted here that these objects should not have any physical connection to the process equipment. The input of these objects and the output must be isolated. If not, then flexible bellows can be mounted to ensure physical isolation of objects. The purpose is weight of objects to be exerted on load cell only, not on the building structure. The indicator is installed in nearby vicinity of the load cell and output for 220 milliamps can be taken to PLC or DCS, or a Profibus connection can be hooked up with the controller so that you can have a remote tear and spark connection. Process industry also encounters dynamic measurement by belt wear, wave feeder, solid flow feeders. Here the load cell assembly called transom assembly is kept as a part of equipment in which the load is transferred from running belt to transom assembly. Mostly the load is considered 0.5 meter on the other side of the load mounting, load cell mounting. This transformer assembly can be single or dual load cell supplied. Having a dual load cell assembly considered to be accurate, which is also the demand of dynamic measurement. The same with solid flow feeder or monitor. There is a curved impact plate which host load is transferred to 102 load cell. Due to this impact load of flowing material, high frequency fluctuation occur in a load cell assembly. To compensate, an oil damping assembly is used, which results in high frequency noise reduction. These dynamic measurements have less accuracy than in comparison to static measurement for obvious reason. Now let's move to the measurement circuitry. The output received in terms of millivolt is converted into physical readings. Here the signal goes through various kind of operation like filtering, amplification, A to D conversion, and then signal goes to digital processing unit for tearing and span calibration facility. This unit may have a RS232 port to provide data to enterprise solution software or SAP or to some invoice generation system. In the latest development, intelligent digital load cell replacing older generation load cell. The analog load cell has some issues like signal is affected by ambient temperature variation, also electrical noise or interference causes false millivolt to superimpose on the cable length. It may curb the reading. A 4-wire load cell has inherent voltage drop over cable length. Due to these reasons, signal accuracy gets compromised. All these issues have been addressed in intelligent load cell. In the same analog load cell, an inbuilt digital transmission module is added along with the sensor. Now this forms the intelligent load cell. This digital transmission module is loaded with signal amplification, filtering, A to D conversion, microprocessor chip, temperature composition, as well as required software for scale conversion and calibration. By connecting an intelligent load cell to laptop directly to RS232 port, you can take reading in ASCII format. If you want, you can also get 4 to 20 milliamps of Fibus connectivity with local indicator. As the output signal from the load cell is in digital form, then there is no problem of interference, transient noise in long transmission cable. It's also this eliminated. Typical analog load cell indicator has a 16-bit analog to digital converter, by which you get only 50,000 counts or steps. But in intelligent load cell, it has inbuilt 20-bit analog to digital converter, which gives you 10 lakh counts or steps. A weighing system consists of 4 such intelligent load cell. You get 40 lakhs counts or steps. Now you can imagine what level of resolution you would be achieving in this intelligent load cell, which we cannot think of having traditional analog load cell. So friend, this was all about load cell. How do you like this video? You can comment on our comment section, or you can have some query or doubt if you have. We will try to clear this doubt. Thank you. Bye-bye.